Hello and welcome to our conversation with Minister Peter Bethlenfalvy, Ontario's President of the Treasury Board and Minister responsible for digital and data transformation. At the Oakville Chamber of Commerce, our Government Relations and Advocacy Committee has spent much of the last year engaging industry leaders and change makers to understand the importance of data and how our governments can harness innovation to create a more competitive business climate and more livable communities. Our committee has written policies that have been adopted by our colleagues by both the Ontario and Canadian chambers, and we will soon launch a call to action for a collaborative way forward here in Oakville. This will also include hosting conversations like the one we're having this morning. Before I turn it over to the chair of our GR committee, Chris Barnier, I would like to introduce the speaker today. Peter Bethlenfalvy is Ontario's President of the Treasury Board, Minister responsible for Digital and Data Transformation, and the MPP for Pickering-Uxbridge. As Minister responsible for Digital and Data Transformation, he leads the government's transformation and modernization efforts that seek to make government services more convenient, reliable, and accessible to the people of Ontario. His responsibilities include overseeing the Audit and Accountability Committee, the Future State Modernization Committee, and the Ontario Digital Service. Prior to entering public service, Minister Bethlenfalvy served in senior leadership roles for financial institutions such as the President and Chief Operating Officer of TD Securities and Co-President of DBRS. Minister Bethlenfalvy holds a Bachelor of Science and a Master's of Business Administration from McGill University, which included a year at Peck School of Management, Paris, and a Master's of Arts in Political Science from the University of Toronto. Minister, thank you for joining us today. We look forward to a timely and engaging discussion. Now, over to you, Chris.
Thank you, Drew. So, Minister, thank you so much for taking the time to join us today. We know that certainly in present circumstances, there's so many polls on the time of members of cabinet. And as Drew mentioned off the top, this whole notion of digital and data transformation is very important to our members and is something that we're spending a lot of time on in our advocacy side. And to have you here today as President of the Treasury Board and as Minister responsible for Ontario's data and digital transformation strategy, really looking forward to hearing some of your remarks and hearing about the things that you're working on. So in particular, you've been tasked with leading this strategy for Ontario. Can you talk a little bit high level about what this digital data strategy encompasses and where you see the opportunity for Ontario to embrace and leverage new technologies?
Well, thank you, Chris. Always great to be with you and good to see you again, Chris. And thank you, Drew, as well. And really a kind thank you to join all of you and appreciate you giving me the opportunity. And before I answer that question, I just want to acknowledge the significant role that you play in Oakville and through the Chamber of Commerce. And it's a tough time for a lot of our businesses in this province. And we have to really work together to ensure that we can do everything we can to support the small, medium, and large businesses across Ontario, and Oakville's a key part of that. And I really know that today more than ever, we need to stand up for those job creators across Ontario and provide those key supports as they continue to contribute to our communities. I would also say, amidst a global pandemic, businesses across the world have had to rethink and retool their operations to really embrace this and adapt to this unprecedented challenges. And frankly, so has government. Governments also have to rapidly embrace change. And that's why last month, Premier Ford and I released the Ontario Onwards, Ontario's COVID-19 Action Plan, or a people-focused government. Now, this groundbreaking plan includes more than 30 signature projects that will improve the way people and businesses interact with government, saving time while making government operations more efficient, with the ultimate goal of providing more convenient, more reliable, and more accessible programs and services for Ontarians. Simply put, we're building a government that works for people, how they want it, when they want it, and where they want it. But I know we can't do it alone. We really need to work across borders, across party lines, across levels of government, and together with the private sector to respond to the pandemic and tackle future challenges. That's why it's so important that we hear from organizations like yours who represent our province's job creators and entrepreneurs, and about how we can simplify the government's role in people's lives and their businesses, and really put businesses and customers, I come from the private sector, really at the center of everything we do. And so thank you for giving me the opportunity to answer some of your questions and give you more insights and get your feedback on the things that we should be doing together. You asked about the digital and data. So yes, my day job is Treasury Board President. And of course that we just had our budget a few weeks ago, and $185 billion of spending is unprecedented. We will do whatever it takes to protect the safety and health of individuals, families, and businesses as we get through this COVID unprecedented challenge that we have in front of us. There is light at the end of the tunnel with vaccines, but we still have a way to go. The other part, and you mentioned it, that I'm now the minister responsible for digitization and data across all of government. And this is the opportunity of, in a sense, to accelerate some of the changes we were already working on. And for example, in our healthcare system before COVID, we had the technology and the ability to deliver physician consultations, for example, online, virtually. But it represented less than 1% of meetings with your physician. Now it's around 50%. So clearly, for many reasons, people want to connect virtually, be it physical health, be it mental health. And it's the same for businesses too. We have, for example, 56 things that government requires businesses to do for permits and licenses and a whole host of things that they have to do in person. Our goal is to digitize all that, because that frees up time, it's more effective, and that's how we'll be more productive as a society. And those are the types of things, Chris, that we in government, along with the private sector and academia and the public sector, can work together and across, as I said, multiple lines, municipalities at the provincial level and the federal level. And it can be things like the COVID Alert app, for example, where we work with Shopify, we work with BlackBerry, we got some code from Alberta, my team put it together, and then we worked with the federal government to launch it. And now it's now over 5 million users, very safe, very secure. It's in Ontario, I think over 4,000 keys have been input, and it's many people have used it to teachers, for example, who've publicly said, you know, I got alerted on the COVID Alert app. That's real time. So I didn't go into school. I didn't teach. I got forewarned. So there's many, many things that we can do together. And the Ontario Onwards plan really galvanizes all those things and gets things done.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Minister. And I can tell you, I have that app on my phone and would certainly encourage everyone else to do the same. You mentioned a lot of things there, Minister. And somebody who watches the Premier's press conferences every day, I did take a lot of interest, and I know you're up there often with them, when you talked about that digital and data transformation strategy and the 30 different things that your government is going to be doing. And I'd like to ask you about a couple of those. Sure. One of the things you mentioned is certainly as a local chamber, a lot of our advocacy is focused at the local level. And as our chamber president mentioned to you, we're intending to do some work, and we want to work in collaboration with our municipal government to do some of the kinds of things that you're doing at the provincial level. Can you talk a little bit about what you're doing and what your government is doing to work with municipalities to support them and help them embrace these new technologies and opportunities?
Well, it's a great question, Chris, and thanks for asking it. Multiple things. One of the first things we did was allow municipalities to meet virtually. Believe it or not, they couldn't meet virtually before the pandemic. Now council can meet virtually. We also launched pre-pandemic, but we've doubled down on it, the modernization fund that we've given funds to all 444 municipalities across the province to give them funds in the first wave unconditionally to modernize, to find shared services, to digitize or find software for HR, for payroll, for a whole host of things to really become more productive. So that's one example. Another area that we're working closely with municipalities is through our broadband fund. And we talk about all this connectivity, but if you don't have good broadband, if you don't have good bandwidth, and that's so important for individuals, as I mentioned, if you want to connect with people individually, but for businesses as well. The e-commerce platforms are so significant in this world. Many small businesses don't have an e-commerce platform. So the broadband initiative through what we call the Improving Connectivity in Ontario program, we just upped our investments in that by doubling the $150 million to over $300 million. But in addition to that, we've announced in our last budget an additional $680 million for broadband. So what that is really almost $1 billion to work with municipalities, to work with local providers who know where those connectivity issues are, because that's a huge boost for small businesses. In addition, we have, I believe it's a $60 million fund called the Main Street Digital Fund, which small businesses, what businesses can apply for to also get funds from the government to develop their e-commerce platforms, which is so important. We also have things like a program for PPE, well, not a modernization thing, but it's also for businesses 2 to 9 employees who can get $1,000 per business to fund PPE, because you want to make your customers safe and your employees safe. So there's a range of programs that we've got in place. And finally, we sit at and engage very directly, not only through AMO, the Association of Municipalities of Ontario, and the large urban mayors and the rural urban mayors and so forth. We sit on the association's digital task force, where we get a lot of the input and the ideas right from municipalities as to the types of things that we need to focus on. And I'll give you one quick example, cybersecurity. You know, does it make sense for 444 municipalities or regions, large cities as well, to put in place the best practices for cybersecurity, because we're all vulnerable in this more digital world to hackers, to fraud, to cyber theft, and so on. So these are the types of things, Chris, that we're working at. We're putting money in behind these types of initiatives, where we have forums to have active conversations. And then doing it where it makes sense, doing it together.
Thank you, Minister. You know, you touched on a lot of things, in part where I was going to go next with the 5G strategy. And certainly that's very important to Oakville. And we recognize that it is central to any kind of big data strategy, automation, automated factories, so many aspects of what it takes for businesses and government to do better. So thank you for touching on that piece. Again, when I watched you at the press conference, when you're talking about those 30 things that Ontario is doing, and you touched on this a little bit earlier about that concept of a digital wallet. I think a lot of that's going to be a really interesting thing when you think about all the times that people need to use their ID to do transactions. And thinking about that, even from a business perspective, a lot of our members are going to be in financial services and elsewhere. Can you talk a little bit more about what that entails and where you're going with this strategy and where there's opportunities for you to work with the private sector?
Another great question, and thank you for that, Chris. By the way, I should mention the investment that we're making in the Ford plant in Oakville. And that's really, looking forward. We have incredible resources in this province. We have incredible talent. We have incredible workers, labor, businesses, and in terms of technology, I mean, we're world beating here. So how do you bring all these things together to really make things easier, simpler, more efficient? And so the digital identity and the digital wallet, let me try to bring that back to ground it in some practical sort of applications. Businesses, I think I mentioned 56 transactions have to be done in person for a business getting a permit, getting licenses and so forth. You know, that's a lot of time and effort and never easy to navigate those sort of things. A digital wallet puts all your credentials on that wallet, so your smartphone or tablet or whatever, and so that you don't have to verify that information over and over again. I'm making the applications digital and streamlined. And on the back end, why that's so important is the data. There's only one business, there's only one person, but the records in government are kept in multiple ministries, and you have to kind of put that information over and over again. To simplify all that is very powerful. Let me give another example. We're about to embark on a vaccination program where we're looking to vaccinate millions of people. Well, today, your vaccination records are typically paper-based. Think about the 500,000 parents who put their children in daycare every year. Every year, they got to verify those immunization records, and they have to, it's paper-based. Putting that on your digital wallet will not only streamline for the individual, the parent, but also the school boards and the daycare centers that have to admit those children into the daycare programs. And vaccination records, if you travel, are paper-based as well if you go to parts of the world. So another application that you could put it safely, securely, privacy protected. We've shown that with the COVID Alert app, that we can do things that are safe, that are secure, that are privacy protected. And so the information privacy officer and office here in Ontario and in Ottawa, we work very closely with to ensure privacy is secure and make sure that they are very secure from a cyber perspective. But it's businesses' data, it's individual data that we want to harness. It's your data. And how do we make it simpler and easy? So those are some examples of why I think Ontario can be the leading jurisdiction really in the world with regard to things like digital identity, a digital wallet, help you open up bank accounts, help you renew your driver's license because you've got all your credentials on your app, on your phone securely, that you don't have to go in line. If you want to go in line, that'll always be an option. We're not taking that away, but we want to give people and businesses options to be able to make so they can free up time to do the things that they really want to do.
Thank you, Minister. You touched on this, and I think having a minister here, you have to ask about COVID. And I know that it's been very difficult, as you touched on, for families, for businesses of all sizes. Some have never been busier, and others haven't had opportunity to work. And as you mentioned, it's been tough, and we know the premier goes up every day and talks to Ontarians and is transparent about what's going on. And as you touched on, there's a lot that your government's trying to do to help. And in particular, as a chamber, we think about our small businesses, which are most vulnerable. You talked about some of the things. If you could expand a little bit more on what your government is doing to help small businesses and even how your digital data strategy has helped that.
Yeah, thank you for that, Chris. First off, I mean, it's heartbreaking. I have a lot of those small businesses, medium-sized businesses, and Drew mentioned I'm the MPP for Pickering Uxbridge. I talk to them every day almost, and we really, it's a very difficult situation. Health and safety of people in Ontario is paramount, but so is the health and safety of our businesses. It's the economic engine of this province. But more than that, it's people's livelihoods. It's their capital. They're taking the risks, their sweat equity that they're putting into their businesses. So this is really, really a real big blow to those businesses. So we're going to try, and you see the premier, thank you for mentioning that, Chris. I mean, you could see it. He's a business guy. He feels it every single day. These are very difficult choices that we have to make. In regard to the types of things that we're doing to try to help those businesses, I'll touch on some by no means all of them, but we did announce that we put in $600 million to help those small businesses that are affected by either a red zone or a lockdown, which of course in Peel and Toronto are in lockdown. So that affects, and the red zones affects your region. The $600 million is supports to basically pay for electricity and gas. So that's an important part of the cost equation. A property tax. So we're paying for all the property tax through that period. And the federal government is put through legislation and they will be coming on board to also pick up. We've been picking up the federal portion of the property tax. They're going to be stepping in to pick up that portion as well going forward. The working with the federal government, I touched on that before. We have to do this together. They're providing supports on the rent side, and we'll be providing supports on the wages up to 65%. And for those businesses, small businesses that severely impacted, up to 90%. So we're on the first level trying to help out with the cost side. The second side, of course, is to try to, and you've seen the premier very much, support your small business. You know, this is a time, and we've seen communities, not just in Oakville, but across this province, you know, communities have really rallied around those businesses, and we have to continue to support those businesses, whether it's curbside pickup or e-commerce, you know, ordering from your local local business. And we're going to continue to invest and support those businesses, and we will get through this. The next few months are going to be extremely difficult, but we'll get through this with the vaccine, and we really will come out of this stronger. We're putting in place, as part of the Ontario Onwards program, Invest Ontario, standing up an agency to really compete for capital and for business in this province. So the Ford plant is a great example in Oakville, where we partnered with the federal government to kind of connect that last mile to make the investment so that Ford, who's putting up their private capital, comes to Canada, comes to Ontario, comes to Oakville. And as you know, there are many spin-off jobs that will come as a result of that. So those are the types of things that we are doing to really help help businesses, help employers. A couple other things I'll quickly mention are the business education tax, which are municipal, providing funding for that and giving relief for municipalities and putting it back into businesses. The property tax, the small business tax, where municipalities want to provide some relief, we'll provide funding for that. The employer health tax, providing relief there. So we're trying to do a range of things to really help bridge us and through this, what we call the support phase of the pandemic, and then really starting to focus on recovery. And we put $4.5 billion in our last budget to start the steps to build back stronger, if you will.
Thank you, Minister. You've been so incredibly generous with your time, and really appreciate it all that you've helped us learn about Ontario's strategy for digital data transformation. A lot of really exciting things happening in Ontario that will be great for our businesses and great for citizens at large. Really appreciate you taking the time to talk to us about all that your government's doing to help the business community through COVID. I know it's tough and it's not easy. And also just want to say thank you for your public service. I know you left a very lucrative and successful career in the private sector. And I think for when you think about a lot of people who come to the Oakville Chamber of Commerce, to see people like yourself step into public service to leverage all of the talent and experience that you bring from the private sector to basically be in service to the rest of us. I sincerely appreciate it. So with that, I'll say thank you very much for your time today, Minister.
Well, thank you, Chris. And, thank you for those comments on public service. You know, you learn, you earn. And I think the third piece is you return, and public service is a noble cause. And thank you for the Oakville Chamber of Commerce. You're an important key part of the business community, of course. And we'd love to hear more from you, through you, and directly from businesses. All ideas, we're open and want to hear from you.
Thanks very much, Minister.
Thank you.